You know, 70 years ago when Jeep started making vehicles, this is what they were intended to do. Climb rocks, go on the beach, really utilize their trail-rated four-wheel drive system. Now, this particular vehicle, the Liberty, is not exactly the best Jeep out there. What I mean is that it's very dated technology. The original one came out in 2002. That generation lasted until 2007. This is the second generation. It comes in three models. Sport is your base model. Then you have a Latitude. Then you have the top of the line, which is a limited jet. And believe it or not, this vehicle, as seen here, tops out at around $34,000, which, in my opinion, is just a lot of money for not a lot of vehicle. It's not very comfortable. It certainly has some functionality, but for, you know, less money, you can get a vehicle like the Nissan Xterra, for example, which in my opinion takes the compact sport utility vehicle to the proper level and is a much better example of what you could do with that type of vehicle. The exterior styling of the Jeep is very military-like, kind of utilitarian, as you can see. A lot of kind of hard, edgy surfaces, but that's the look that most people want when they buy a Jeep. You don't want some nicely rounded thing. Under the hood of the Jeep Liberty is a very unimpressive 3.7-liter V6 engine that produces just 210 horsepower and 235 pound-feet of torque. And it's mated to a very outdated 4-speed automatic transmission. These numbers, I'm telling you, are just not very impressive. And when you consider this particular vehicle is almost $35,000, it makes the value proposition almost non-existent. So what I'm holding here is not exactly a mud flap. This, believe it or not, is the driver's side floor mat. And you can see how little it is, about the size of a big mud flap. This is what fits in here because that's all the space you have. Because of this massive area here that houses the transmission, you have virtually no room. It's fine when you got your foot on the gas pedal, but just try and bring it back a little bit and you're gonna get stuck right here. This is just a very poor design and, in my opinion, poor engineering on Jeep's part. So this is the coolest part, and probably the only thing I like about the Jeep Liberty. It's called a sky slider full open roof. As you can see, it's just a massive space. This is a canvas top. It's about a $1,200 option, and again, the best part of this vehicle because you essentially have a sunroof for all five passengers. You know, from a driver's perspective, you know, the Liberty's just not that great. Again, I look at the price point and what else is out there in the segment, and I think this is probably dead last for my money. It's an okay vehicle. It, you know, handles okay for a truck. The steering is not very responsive. Again, the transmission, because it's a 4-speed, it means that the engine's gonna rev a lot louder at like highway speeds, and essentially you're gonna get a very noisy and not a very fuel efficient vehicle, which is why we're getting about 17, 18 miles to gallon out of a relatively small engine. A lot of people who do buy vehicles in this segment and don't take them off-road expect a certain level of luxury, or I should say some poshness, which the Liberty just doesn't offer. As you can see, it's very kind of proletariat here. It's very basic. They tried to make it look better with this fake kind of gray and black wood, but it's very plasticky. Even though Chrysler has made some improvements, they still got a long way to go with the Jeep Liberty. The Jeep Liberty is ideal for people who are really going to use it the way it was intended to, which is to go on, you know, soft surfaces like the sand, or take it off-roading, maybe into some mud and snow. But if you're going to drive around town, I don't really recommend this car because it's rather heavy, doesn't get very good fuel economy. We averaged about 17, 18 miles to gallon. The engine is pretty outdated. The transmission is pretty outdated. Basically, you've got an outdated design here with some outdated technology. I think you could do much better for your money.